was because they never did successfully reunite him with his natal pod. And so he wound up going to Norway and reassumed human contact there. He actually was kind of a big sensation in Norway. All these tourists would come to this little fjord where he was and see him. His trainers from the Humane Society of the U.S., including Colin Bear, went over there to Norway and set up shop there, and they were monitoring him, but he was clearly healthy, seemed healthy anyway, certainly was big and fat and eating lots and feeding himself. There was no issue, as has been claimed, that he was starving. Rather the opposite, he was rather well fed and doing well. And then suddenly one day he developed this respiratory ailment that was very similar to a common respiratory ailment that kills captive killer whales. And he passed away within 2 days of contracting this ailment. So the captive industry said this was a classic example of why you can't return these animals to the wild. But really all we learned was that what you can't do is return them to the wild without finding their natal pod, the pod that they live with. Because they're such social animals, you really need to have their families around them, and they need to be able to, as part of their ability to hunt. But also, as we learned with a lot of whales, including Luna, whose story I don't have time to tackle here. But Luna was the L-pod whale who got lost up in Utica Sound on the north side of Vancouver Island. And the people who interacted with him there just came away profoundly impressed by his social needs. This whale is so eager for social interaction that he actually started hanging out with sea lions. And Lance Garrett Leonard from the Vancouver Aquarium actually recorded him imitating sea lion sounds.